Typhoon Haiyan is known as Typhoon Yolanda in the Philippines, and it occurred on the 8th of November 2013. It was an exceptionally powerful tropical cyclone that destroyed portions of Southeast Asia, particularly the Philippines. It is the deadliest Philippine typhoon on record, killing at least 6,201 people in that country alone. Haiyan is also the strongest storm recorded at landfall, and officially the strongest typhoon ever recorded in terms of wind speed. As of January 2014, bodies were still being found. According to United Nations officials, about 11 million people have been affected or have been left homeless. Typhoons. A typhoon is a mature tropical cyclone that develops in the western part of the North Pacific Ocean, referred to as the Northwest Pacific Basin. There are six requirements for typhoon formation and development: sufficiently warm sea surface temperatures, atmospheric instability, high humidity in the lower to middle levels of the troposphere, enough Coriolis force or a deflection of moving objects when they are viewed in a rotating reference frame to develop a low pressure center, a pre-existing low level focus of disturbance, and low vertical wind shear. Here are some before and after images of some parts of the Philippines.
More now on our top story. Super Typhoon Haiyan. Last hour, the storm made landfall in the eastern Philippines, and it has all the makings of a major disaster. Torrential rain and winds of more than 300 kilometers per hour. We're going to go to Andrew Stevens. He is there in Tacloban. Andrew, he joins us now live. What's it looking like there right now?
Well, conditions continue to deteriorate quite sharply, Patricia. We are still according to estimates of the storm chaser James Reynolds, who's a frequent visitor on our show, of course, who's with us here, we're probably about an hour or so away from the actual full brunt of the storm. But at the moment, it is significant gusts. We're quite well protected where we're standing at the moment, but looking out across the city behind us, we can see, I'm starting to see loose iron starting to be taken off roofs, things like that. So it is continues to build. This is at the high end of a Category 5 storm. That's what we're being told. The local media is now referring to it as the storm of the century, Patricia, just to give you an idea. But certainly we've got another 3 hours or so of this. Where it hit landfall is about 300 or 400 kilometers away from where we are now. So we're expecting another 2 or 3 hours of intense winds. Perhaps then the eye will pass over. At this stage, it looks like it could pass directly over us. Obviously, that's things can change there. And then we've got the other side of the storm to weather. So the people in the Philippines are looking at several hours still of these incredibly strong winds. And accompanying that, of course, the very low pressure, strong winds, that combines to produce a surge, a storm surge it's called, where you get a significant increase in the sea level. So that is obviously a real concern as well. This is quite a low-lying city, and along the coast you see a lot of dwellings, of houses right hard up against the sea all the way along. So the question is, have they been evacuated? There has been evacuations. Whether there were enough, whether people realized the severity of what was about to hit them, we don't know yet.
Right now I want to bring in Tom Sater, who's been tracking this storm for us. So Tom, what's it looking like?
Well, conditions are going to continue to deteriorate, not only where Andrew is, but, you know, for the next 25 million people, the next that we'll see this system move from the east to the west. We're looking at a situation, in fact, you can see this is the greatest storm, not only for this year, but this is going to go down in history. Now, there's several elements that you look at with a storm of this size to actually rank them, and we won't know exactly where this would rank in history for maybe some time, but it's easy to say it could be in the top 10. Could be in the top 15. We've never seen one this strong and affect such a vulnerable area and a coastline which is defenseless.